Good morning from Bullhead City and welcome to Blazing New Trails. It's an exciting day because Linda and I are finally going to pick up our 337 Reflection camper, and we've been so ready. It's our last full day here in Bullhead City before we start heading home, and we are so ready to be home. But first, I'm putting in a quick workout on the track, took a quick break, get some water, and then we'll head back and start pulling things together so that we can drop off the camper and make the exchange. So I will see you back at the campsite.
Good morning. It's moving day. So Gary's out for a run and I am trying to pull things together here. We were given the impression that we were going to be moving like a week ago. So I have had all this stuff boxed up and ready to go and trying to live around it and walk over things. We're over a week. Something else I did as I was packing things up as the smaller like grocery bags full of things, I ended up putting those back in cabinets just to get them off the floor, out of the way, give me some extra room. So all of those cabinets up there are full, and the ones above the TV and the ones above the theater seats. So it helps just to get rid of some of it. I didn't think I was going to need a lot of boxes. The first place I went, I only got like four. Then we went back somewhere else and got four more. We got some out of the dumpster just by chance. There were a few there. Are they still there?
Score. They're here.
One thing I wanted to bring to your attention right away was this. Do not forget when you're moving out of an RV into another one, especially you're selling the one that you're in, trading it in, whatever. Don't forget to log out of all of your apps, HBO, Netflix, YouTube TV, Disney, whatever it is. And don't just exit. Make sure you sign out. Hopefully. Yep. Done. Don't forget, if you have YouTube TV, that you have the little thing in the back, like the little flash drive thing to have YouTube TV that you get from Amazon. I almost forgot to take that out.
I'm back at the camper after my run, and Lynn and I are getting things organized. We're getting packed because we've got to get to RV country, but you want to stick around because we're going to give you a tour of the camper as well as share our first impressions and tell you about the lessons learned from this entire experience. So you're not going to want to miss all of that. Feeling besides stressed
because we're going to be 45 minutes late to our appointment. Yeah,
well, we may be late, but you know what, what they put us through, I'm really not too feeling too bad about that. But anyway, we're taking her to Trader Inn and pick up our new 337, so you got to be excited about that.
I'll be glad when the day is over. Hopefully everything will go our way, and if not, we'll handle it, because when you RV, you never know. Things change all the time, which is something I have had to learn to deal with, because I am the consummate planner. Everything has to be planned.
And control freak. There's a nice big turn lane. Here's where our new chapter begins.
we've got this new trailer. We've got to move, because we got to move our belongings from the 303 to the 337, and we've got to get this done quick. Ha!
Yeah! Let's get it done! Because I'm hungry, and I want to make dinner later in my new RV! Yeah!
Okay, Linda, I drew up a plan. Just like the legendary John Madden would do for his football team.
Boom, we cross him. Boom!
So, we've got several things that we need to get covered in conjunction with the move. First and foremost is we have a walkthrough with Jake. Now, that's not Jake with State Farm.
Coach, Jake from State Farm.
That's Jake with RV Country.
Okay.
And then, we've got the finance paperwork with Stephanie.
Yay! Yes. Pay the money.
Pay the bills. And then we move.
Yay!
So,
how do we do it?
Here's what I've got in mind. So, divide and conquer. We've got the 303 and the 337. And so, we'll both take our own areas, and you'll start with the kitchen first and move all those boxes to the 337 kitchen.
Okay.
I'll work in the living room and start moving things to the 337.
Okay.
And then we go to the bedroom and then the bathroom. Oh.
Ew, we got the bed too, because we got a sleep number bed. We've got to take out the king size bed and we have to put in the queen size sleep number.
And that's going to be fun. But that's divide and conquer.
All right.
And it's done.
It is done. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Grr!
They've condensed it a little bit there. So you still have water pump and front cap and slide lights that are just underneath here on this side. But when you disconnect it from your truck, you get done. You know, you pressed front, raised it, you pulled out from underneath. That's your last hitch setting.
So you have a lot of solar.
Okay. We have a lot of solar. Look at that. Boy, it's hard to get around them.
Oh, you have a Furion on-demand hot water heater, gas hot water heater. You're gonna have an up and down temperature setting.
Now, one thing that we feel that we really do need to talk about, and we are not negative people, but dealing with the RV Country salesman wasn't a really good experience.
He was a nice guy. When we met him at the rally, super nice, of course, very personable. He's a salesman.
Extremely knowledgeable.
Yes.
But after the sale was done, he did stay in contact, and we did have some of our questions answered, but trying to get a deep dive into the actual arrival date on the camper, that was like pulling teeth.
But let me see if I can't get a better answer for you, and then I'll give you guys a call back.
Do we know when it left Grand Design? Once we did get to the dealership, though, those people were fantastic.
Yes.
And they really moved heaven and earth to get the camper ready for us, to do their PDI, to add the solar panel, and then do the walkthrough and make it so that we could get out of town when we wanted to. But now we're going to move on to our first impressions, things that we really enjoy about the camper, and share those with you. And maybe it might kind of whet your appetite and give you a hankering to wanting one of your own.
All right, we're glad you're here for our walkabout.
Are you leaving us, Mick? You going back home?
No, I thought I'd got a walkabout.
We're going to start off with the outside first. We got a few things that we really, really love, and it's only been 3 days since we've had this camper, but already we're falling in love. So first we're going to start with the basement, and Linda, let me get this door here first. We knew we were going to have this, but the Nautilus system has been improved from the standpoint there were 5 levers and now there's 3. So a lot more compact and a lot easier to use. The other thing I really, really like, look at this rubber matting. This flooring really can take a beating over time, and having this rubber matting, as my friend Stan at Over the Hill Adventures would say, it's a game changer. So the other feature about the basement, and Linda, let's get a little closer, is just all of the extra space that we've got. Now, I'm disorganized right now, so don't pay any attention to that, but I've got a plan, and we do have a plan to get everything organized in a better place where I can get to it. Another thing which is really kind of different is we gotta have a place to attach Rosie's lead.
And she's all here now. Yeah. There's my girl. Hi, Rosebud.
And then we finally got our Moride steps.
The flip-up kind.
Flip-up. We couldn't really have them with our 303 because of the steps up into the bedroom and the bathroom. So these just flip up, and so easy that Linda can even do it with one hand. So we like that. And then we had this installed on our 303, but
aftermarket.
Aftermarket. This came as a feature with the trailer, and we really, really like it. And last but not least,
we came across this on the just by accident, the window.
We've got, yeah, this window.
You'll have to go up the step.
Well, why don't you go up the step?
Well, why don't you come over here then? So, I was looking out the window one day. I noticed, I was like, oh my gosh, this is clear. Our other one had a design to it, you know, it was a texture. But, and I'm looking at it, I'm like, oh my gosh, look at this, Gary. I made him get up and come over and look. So, nice for when you want some privacy and then...
Or maybe you want some sunlight.
If you want to, you know, check on your neighbors, you can get clear glass. And then, another thing that we didn't know we were going to have was not only do you just have your regular screen, but on the inside, man, this is tough. This is for dogs. So your dog isn't going to go right through this little mesh screen. It's something a lot heavier down here. Love it.
Yeah, it's really heavy duty.
Yeah.
So, nice features.
Always. It's a grand design. We're going inside. Going to see all the goodies there. Let's go. Okay, starting from coming in the door, we're going to wrap around the living space down here, starting with the dining room. I mean, it's table and chairs, but the table swivels. So let me show you how that works. There's a little a knob on the bottom, and you just pull it down and then bring it toward you and then let go. Then it swivels this way. So you can put your chairs here and look out at your beautiful view outside. Right now, we're looking at an empty campground. One thing that I really liked was that they've changed the location of the air conditioning vents. In the 303, the 2021 303s, it was here. And it would always, first of all, it was really loud. Second of all, it would blow right on me. This is my seat over here on the couch. If you're on the chairs, it's not as bad. But over there, it would blow on me. And I don't like the cold. So now they've moved it over. It's a smaller footprint or ceiling print in this case. And it's not as loud. Game changer. One thing that makes the trailer feel a lot more like home is having a larger stove and a stovetop and oven. This is a little bigger. I like the grates. There's only two big grates. And man, these things are heavy. With three burners on our 303, I had to hold a button down here and have this open, the oven open, turn the dial, put my head down, and look for the pilot light to go on every time I started the oven. So this is really nice. Turn it, click, click, click. It goes on, and you're ready to go. Love that. The other thing right next to it that I really like, on our last trailer, I added my own motion sensor lights in here, which if you watch one of our videos, I had that on there. Now they have an LED strip that goes from one side all the way down to the bottom, and it helps a lot. So I think even if you don't have lights, to get one of those little LED strips and you can put them in yourself, that would work great. I don't know why I didn't think about that. Online and looking at pictures, you could see that there were a couple of little things that you think, oh, I wonder if that's like an option that you have to pay extra for. But no. Come and look.
What are we,
top drawer. Got my silverware. And then, surprise, surprise.
How about that?
Some extra storage. So I love that. And then, the other thing that I really liked that I thought was an option, trash cans, two trash cans. They're smaller than the trash can that I had under the sink in our last RV. So I feel these like really fast. And but anyway, they're helpful and they don't take up, they take up one cabinet. But then I have all the space under here for cleaning supplies and towels and whatever. And lastly, a new refrigerator. If you're familiar with the 303, it has a very small, I think it's only 12 cubic feet. This one's 16, so, it seems quite a bit bigger. The other one had two doors up here, two separate freezers, and then a big French doors to open into a refrigerator. So now we have side by side, no frost. That's a big deal, because the other one, oh my God, that was the bane of my existence. So, tons of room in here with drawers in the bottom.
Well, but Linda, the last...
deep.
Yeah.
Very deep. This side's a lot deeper than this side. So, but still, it's nice. Yeah. It's those little things.
And the shower. I love the shower. And Jim, you were right. You left us a note and said that you're 6'6", and that you fit easily in the shower. And you were right. There's so much space in there. I almost don't want to get out. It's great. And the other thing, too, is there's no skylight. In our last RV, in our last camper, after about 2.5 years or so, we had a couple cracks in the skylight. And I love the fact that there's no skylight here. There is plenty of light that comes through the vent. Door here, but a skylight, I don't think that's really any place in an RV with all of the moving and shaking and things that happen. So the shower is a huge, huge upgrade.
Okay, so now we're in the bedroom, and this RV, we didn't get a choice on having a queen or a king size. We have a Sleep Number bed, it's a queen, but this was built as a king. So, well, it seems like we're going to have to cut off a little bit down here that sticks out. I have towels on these now just wrapped around so that we don't get splinters. But hopefully that's going to give a little extra space on this side so that Gary can have a nightstand. They were able to address my request for a nightstand, at least on one side, they said. One thing I don't like is that they did not center the headboard on the wall. I'm not sure what that's about. But other than that, it's great. We love it. The other thing that, I mean, this was a big selling point, and one thing that for the past 2 years, we've wanted this camper specifically because we would get closet space. So up until now, just recently, this was all one big closet. And so this closet here is for a washer and dryer. Stackable or one and two, but all the controls are in here, down there. We're just, of course, using it for storage right now. But before it had, in one big closet, it had the washer on one side and the dryer on the other. So now it's just a closet. And it also has the shoe storage in the back. And we've just got stuff everywhere. So
still moving in.
Still moving in.
And you'll see Rosie. Rosie's
Hi, Rosie.
Adopted
what are you
this
doing?
Space.
What are you doing down
she
there?
She found her space.
She's got to have her own little section. So those are our favorites. Things that were kind of surprises that we didn't know we were getting. Extras that we haven't had before. But they've made great use of the spaces here. And in our bedroom feels like a bedroom now, not a bedroom. The other one was just big enough for the bed with a little bit of space on either side. So this is just, this is like a palace to us now. It's so big. We love it. We love it all.
So that was fun. We hope you enjoyed that. And I think what we would like before we close is to share maybe some of our lessons learned mm-hmm. through this whole process. I think maybe some of them are pretty
basic knowledge.
Basic, right. But there may be a couple things that we may share with you that you might think, oh, yeah. Wish I would have thought of that.
Yeah, exactly. And in fact, I was watching a video recently and I was like, oh, all this time I've never done that, but made sense. And sometimes we just need a reminder.
Yeah. So, I think, first of all, we did our plan. We kind of planned things out on how we were going to divide and conquer.
Mm-hmm.
So, make sure you have a strategy on how you want to do that and how you're going to get it done. But I think one thing that really gets things moving in a positive way, and you were right on it with what we did here, Linda, is getting things organized and put into boxes and maybe organizing by room or by storage cabinet, the pantry, I mean, whatever it may be. Get it organized so that you know what you've got and really where it needs to go.
And I really didn't think we were going to need very many boxes or totes because, I just didn't think that we had much stuff. I really didn't. And we got boxes, but we had boxes. We had many totes. I used grocery bags. And I ended up taking a box from the old trailer, bringing it into the new one, taking everything out and putting it away, and then taking that box back because I ran out of boxes.
Well, I think that also might touch on another good point is know maybe in advance what you want to keep and maybe what you want to get rid of. Because
yeah.
We tend to collect things and we kind of forget they're there.
And I think that probably full-timers have that more than anybody, because when we're not full-timers, we're on the road. When we go home, we take most things out. I mean, some things, our dishes and silverware and pots and pans, things like that stay. Things that are really staples that are just for the RV.
Well, I think probably another thing that caught us by surprise is we thought we were going to be in and out.
Oh, my gosh.
We thought it was just going to be a slam dunk.
They were telling us, we close at 6 o'clock. And I'm like, okay, couple hours, we'll be here. Sure.
Yeah. It went right up to 6.
Yes. A little after 6 before we left, we kept the guy there,
because
our technician.
Jake, yeah. So just be aware that it's not going to be a slam dunk. It does take some time.
Oh, my gosh. And you will be exhausted. We're not spring chickens anymore. But I think we're in pretty good shape. And we were exhausted. Now, we realized after the fact, we hardly had anything to eat all day. We definitely didn't have lunch. We had a little something for breakfast, but nothing substantial to pull us through. Something to drink. I had had one bottle of water with us that they gave us at signing. But so by the time we finished and got back to our campsite, we were done. Well, I said, you know what? When we get back, I'm going to go get something to eat. I'm just going to get fast food.
We were absolutely toast.
Yeah. And I think it took two nights before we finally, the second night, we finally got a good night's sleep. But it was rough.
So, yeah. Be sure to pace yourself.
Yes.
Probably the next thing, and I call it the one touch, if you can, just touch that item or that box one time. If you can move it, put it away, you're done with it. You don't have to touch it again. So anything you can do to limit the time that you're touching those items, moving them, whatnot, you're going to be much, much further ahead.
Mm-hmm.
So I think another thing, too, is if you've got friends that can help, try to enlist their help. So that'll make it go a lot quicker.
Yeah, we didn't have that luxury.
No, we didn't. And one thing that really bit us in the butt big time, because I think we were just so tired, we did not do that final walkthrough to check to make sure we had moved everything.
Yes.
And there was one cabinet in the bathroom that had towels and some toiletries and things that we had to go back and pick up.
So make sure you open every single cabinet, every door. Look under and over and make sure you have every single thing out of your whole camper.
And I would say not just one person, but two people.
Yeah.
Do it. So another thing that's really important that you should really consider, whether you're selling the camper on your own or trading it in, is things that you purchased on your own. For us, it was just really a couple things. It was the propane tank gauges. There was also
RV lock.
The RV lock, and then the Moride cross braces. I did put the retractable shelf in, but I left that because I want to upgrade and get one that opens on both sides. So other than that, don't forget that, because you don't want to re-spend good money on things that you could really take with you. And I would say last but not least, and Linda, you can speak to this because we learned about it when we bought the 303, and that's to remove all of the apps off the TV.
Oh, yeah.
If you don't want people taking advantage of your account, or whatnot.
Ordering movies that you're paying for.
Yeah.
You always hope that the new owners are nice people and that they are honest and they will log out and log into their own. But you never know. Make sure log out of, sign out. So don't just exit, sign out of everything.
Yep. So hope that helps. Hope that's maybe given you maybe some food for thought, and might help maybe the next time that you change campers. So thanks for being here with us. We've enjoyed having you. Do you have any tips or tricks maybe that we missed, or any stories?
What'd you forget?
But with that, we're going to sign off. We would appreciate if you enjoyed this video, maybe gotten something out of it. Give us a thumbs up, maybe thinking about subscribing to our channel. It helps us to grow and really get the word out to other people about our little channel. And with that, we look forward to seeing you on the trails.
Bye.
Bye for now.